This conference will now be recorded.
Hello friends. So today the market is dedicated to Bitcoin. So this was the reason given for market fall. So there is different reason for market fall. Suddenly comes, suddenly the US bond yield rises and market falls. Then US inflation, market falls and recovers. Then Bitcoin falls, recovers. And this is going on like this. Different stories are being invented for the market to correct actually. So something is being going on actually, but we have to see some proper thing happening in the market in the coming days. So we'll wait for that. Till the time it is going to be range bound like this only. So let's see what is happening in the market. Some data points before the disclaimer. The views whatever mentioned is a personal opinion, and any loss incurred by taking trades based on my view, I am not responsible. Please consult your financial advisor before taking any trades. So first thing is the FI data we'll see. So FI data also, if you see here today, they go almost the squad of 9,000 contracts of index futures. So 22,000 contracts they had long position, today they squared off. The market fall, they square off. Okay, everything they're doing in the opposite direction actually. So are they confused, or they're trying to trap, or they're getting trapped? Nobody knows, only God knows. So because there, since if you see the contract size, what are the holding is very, very, very low, and just trying to enter, exit, they're trying to do something. And here also, if you see here, stock futures is very, very important. If you see here, stock futures are almost 2.5 lakh contracts they had actually. Completely they squared off everything, and now if you see, only 1,38,000, the lowest. If you see here, so much of low. If you just here, sometime back they had almost in April, 195,000 contracts, something like this low they had actually. They completely just sold off. In the cash market data also, if you see, the market is buy and dips actually. And here they're buying in long people. If you see here, they have to see everything together. Some people see only on this index futures, they think their market, they are buying, they're going on long and the market is bullish like that. But actually what they're doing is they're trying to divert here and the squaring of the stock futures here. And here also futures, they are increasing the long puts here. So here long calls they cut down here. Again, they are just trying to get into short mode. This is what's happening here. Overall, they just range bound. They're nothing else. They're not getting to trending mode till now actually. And if you see clients, or they normally what they do when the dips, they're selling the put options. And here they are piling up on the stock futures actually. Now if you see here, they almost reached almost 8 lakhs of stock futures in the long position, and index futures also they're going into long position. So thing is that it's like a tiger, the child and tiger story you'd have heard in the, you know, when you're a kid. That kind of thing happening here. Whenever they just market going down, they're selling the put option, and after the market recovers, they sell this put option. This is what happening. And one sudden day, once they become overconfident and they pile up almost 3 lakhs of index put options, then that's the time it's going to be a big trap. That's what's expecting that'll happen in the market actually. And in case of Propel traders, if you see, they're holding index which is short position, and then here is a long position. There are long call, the call option they shorted, and the put option slightly shorted. So they are not having any great position on either side. Just is a hedge position they are holding. So this is what actually happening in the market now. As of now, there is no trending move seen by any of the market participants. It is a range bound only. Nobody is taking the lead, and neither bulls nor bears are taking lead in the market. Every dip. Now that market is wanted every trader and investor to believe that every dip is a buy, and there is no bears can come in the market permanently, or market cannot crash, and the market will be always on the upside only. That's what the market wants the every participant to believe, you know. That's what is very clear actually. So just understand the underlying tone. And the cash market, surprisingly, today 17 crores they have bought some small amount by FIs. And DIs actually, they sold 876 crores. So net 805 crores was sold in the market actually. Not much actually, but still it is negative only. Institutional participants have sold net in the market. So who bought? Retailers bought. So coming to highest operators, this was a very, very tricky day actually today. If you see 20th May, today's expiry. Yesterday, what was the position here? 34,000 was there. 33,000 means if you see here, 33,000 very good support was there, and here 34,000 very good support resistance was here actually. And in between this 33,500 was there, possible. I was expecting 33,500 could be the reason that market can touch here and take a support actually in case we don't go in the market at 34,000 level. In the morning almost we touched 34,000 level nearby at resistance, and then we came all the way to 33,500. But surprisingly, the 33,300 came as a new participant and came all the way here. Actually, if you see, 33,300 was nowhere yesterday here. Actually, if you see here, 33,300 developed today complete is a new participant actually entered and took the first place, 33,300, which is the expiry level actually. So, and then 33,000 versus this, whatever the options were sold heavily, put options, but it's a very small amount only the value of the put option. And in here also, if you see, 14,900 was level where the support it good for Nifty. So this is what happened in the market today, but it was completely trapped. It's a big trap for the bulls, because majority of people are on the view that market is bullish and every dip will be bought and then the market will go on. But today, the entire day, it is a mini version of what happens, going to happen in the market in the coming days. Just think of the today. Every dip was a majority of people were thinking that the market is going to bounce on every dip actually, but we never went up and then start keep on falling only. The same is going to happen in the bigger time frame in the coming days. The market will be keep on falling, not like March 2020, but definitely in a little higher version, slower version, is going to keep on falling and market will never bounce at some point of time. Because now the market is trying to hand over all the bulls to the retail traders, and then they want to ride the bears. Coming to the next expiry, 27th May, if you see here, 27th May, what is happening here? 33,000 put option is being sold very heavily. Almost 6.87 lakhs of put option open interest is there here for bears for the put options, and the call options are 4,14,000. So 33,000 put and 34,000 call. This is what is being traded now. Like short strangle is being traded now. Now 33,500, there is some put option is there. 3,45,000 put options. So possible that we could see some resistance of 3,40,000. And tomorrow, if there is any rise, 33, like aggressive traders can short 33,500 call options, because there could be resistance for this call option. Now currently trading at 33,500 call option. Now currently trading 467. Now it could face resistance at 505, something like that. Something like that. That's the price it could see resistance. And 34,000 call is trading at 257 now. And that also can see some resistance now. So get ready to short the call options. That's the only way you can make some money in the market. Because only thing is that now tomorrow being the first day of the expiry, and we have to see almost like a short straddle, like lowest straddle is around 1,000 rupees now. Normally it will be around 1,200 at least, but this time it is 1,000. So this time also could be a little trendy, because month end expiry also coming, and weekly and monthly getting joined this time. We have to be very, very careful for a trendy move actually. And many, if you see highest open interest out of top 10, you can see only three things are a put option and everything is a call option. So selling pressure is there actually on every rise. And in case of Nifty also, Nifty is a different story. It is divergence. You can see put options are more supporting there, and then call options are less. So Bank Nifty and Nifty are again are trading in the opposite direction. And here you can see the 15,000 call is a very good resistance, and the next support is seen at 14,800 actually. 14,800. So 14,800, 15,000 short straddle, short triangle being traded out. So this is the way how market is trying to manipulate the traders. And confused, if you're trading both Nifty Bank Nifty, you have to be very, very cautious to trade on only one instrument, because if you trade in a different instrument with different mindset, it becomes difficult actually. So try to be safer. And open interest change, we'll see here. So this week expiry for next month means 27th May expiry. If you see Bank Nifty, so Nifty, we are starting with a bullish note where the PCR is 1.12 and Bank Nifty is on a bearish note with 11.7 lakhs of bearish positions, and PCR is 0.83. So both are in the opposite direction starting the week expiry. And all expiry put together here also, if you see here, if you remember, I mentioned about the buying of this 14,500 put option, which are 123. Today, I think it traded at 160 something, 155, 160 something like that. So whenever the all expiry put together reaching 2.7 crores of bullish position, that's the time is a good time to buy the put option. And after that, if you see here, whenever it's coming to 15 lakhs in various position, one day it is there actually 1.27 crore. Whenever it is there like that time it is a very good time to buy the call option. Looks like it's a very easy method to identify the buying the put option, call option, and on monthly expiries. Here it is a little difficult, but here it is a very ideal method to buy the call option, put option for a swing trades. And in case of a Nifty, if it's a bank Nifty, so only 2 days of bullish position was there, and then again bearish position started actually. And overall, it is a bearish mode, bank Nifty. PCR, okay, both are the same opposite trend we saw already. And the strike PCR, if you see here, we are getting a support at 300. So tomorrow, like there will be gap up, so we can look for shorting the call option. And then look, and then here in case of Nifty also 15,000 call option can be shorted. That's a very good opportunity tomorrow. There is nothing more best trade looks like. And then you can short the 33,000 put option, 33,000 put option, 34,000 call option. These two can be taken as a very ideal trade. And then next is a short straddle, lowest straddle price. If you see, we're starting with 995, roughly 1000 rupees is the 33,500. So the range for the week is 32,500 and 34,500 actually. So I'm not expecting 34,500 to come definitely, and the views are bearish for the coming week. The entire rise what we saw 3 days back, the big move with the mother candle, that need to get at least 50% retest actually. And in case of bank Nifty, 14,950 is the lower straddle, 287. So roughly you can assume 300 points. So 14,950 minus 300, 14,950 plus 300. This is the range for the coming week actually in case of Nifty. And in case of Lakshman Rekha, if you see, with Lakshman Rekha, we are getting into a actually slightly neutral tone actually. So here Lakshman Rekha trailing stop loss bullish, and Lakshman Rekha the original VWAP price is bearish. So it is just a range bound, no profit this time from the Lakshman Rekha technique actually. The weekly midpoint also gave some small profit in case of Bank Nifty Nifty. So overall this month is a range bound move only. So almost we saw like 4 weeks we are in the range bound move for Bank Nifty particularly. And this all reason is going to be for the reason for the SEBI's circular, which is telling that every trade need to be hedged actually. So when everybody is in a safe net, and then the market cannot move on either side because everybody having a protection. Now everybody is now used to get a protection, and that's what is happening in the market now. So when the market is going on the upside, there is a call protection, and then on the downside, put protection is there. So that way the market is not going to go anywhere, and is going to be like this only for several weeks also possibly. Looks like possible that SEBI will remove this barrier and give way for the next move in the market. Otherwise, the market is not going to make any big moves on the either side for several weeks together. That's what is going to happening, and is going to frustrate the traders a lot. If you are not if you are just option buyers, if you are just option sellers, there is no problem. You are going to do the hedging and make some money, some small points, whatever is possible in the small range. And coming to the pivot point chart, so you can see very clearly. You can see here starting from this time, no, March 2021. Almost like 2 months, you can see just we are in a particular range only Nifty. So on every rise, calls are being sold. On every dip, puts are being sold. A complete range bound only. But here the swing high, lower high, lower high, lower high is being formed. Unless you break this 14,400, this level is broken. Then only some move can come on the downside. Otherwise, Nifty is going to be like this only. Between some big range of say 14,400 to 15,400, this 1,000 points range only we are going to see movement in the Nifty actually. A 1,000 point range is a small range for Nifty nowadays. And in case of Bank Nifty, if you see, again we are in a big range only here. If you see here, from starting from March 20th till now, almost like 2 months, we are just inside range of 33,300 and here 32,600. So 1,000 points range, the pivot point is moving, and we are not getting into any range as of now in the Bank Nifty also. So the SEBI rule, this is one of the reason possibly. Also, this is one of the reason, main reason for the market is not moving down or moving up on either side, and is going to be like this for long time. Looks like we are, market is putting pressure on SEBI for the removal of this SEBI circular for margins. If the time is delayed, if SEBI is taking time to remove the circular, then everybody will be coming at a habit of this hedged position, And in spite of the removal of the circular, then they are going to get into this mode only, because once the traders test the habit of getting into a trade position with the hedge, then they are not going to come out of this position. And then now the SEBI will tell for hedged position also the margin is going to increase. That's what is going to happen. So this, they're just trying to get out all the traders from the market, and possibly trading also can be banned in coming days. That's what it looks like. So let's see. And then Camarilla private point, if you see Camarilla levels for tomorrow, Bank Nifty futures a long breakout 33735, and then short breakout 33156, and in case of Nifty future 15029 long breakout, and short breakout 14838, and this is spot level, and this private point 14.84 above this bullish and below this bearish, and in case of Bank Nifty spot 33481 above this is bullish and below this bearish. So something you can assume 33500. Anything market sustaining above 33500, then you can go for around, say you can just go for shorting the put options as the only way. And coming to the key ratios, so Nifty P ratio slightly gone below 30 now, and the Bank Nifty P ratio 22.71. If now the Nifty P ratio is not getting cooled down to around 25 below the levels, then I think some stocks which are having a high P ratio will be taken out from the Nifty, and low P ratio stocks may be replacing. So that way the P ratio will be kept under control, which around 25 levels also possibly. So one shouldn't bother about high P ratio nowadays, because the entire system is there ready to help you to ensure that Nifty is having a low P ratio. We have done already seen the consolidated earnings are being used for the P ratio calculation instead of the standalone earnings. So entire system is protecting the people to be on the long side. So once the bearish move comes, that's the only time you have to be very, very careful to take the position. Till the time, you have to be having a long position with a tight stop loss, or little liberal stop loss also is no exception. Like Bank Nifty, 14,000 can be a stop loss for any long positions. Till the time, you can just try to buy every dips and then try to make some profit and then exit some short positions. Otherwise, 14,000 will be a very good stop loss for any long positions for Nifty particularly. In case of VIX also, if you see, VIX has not gone up anything more than 20. So above 25 only, one should bother about the market crashing or something like that, because I'm not seeing any market getting crashed in the coming days. Possibly if the SEBI circular is not removed, then everybody is going to have a hedge position, and the market is going to be in the range bound of 1,000 points move, particularly Bank Nifty also. Nifty 1,000 points is fine, but Bank Nifty trading 1,500 points, 2,000 points range for weeks together is going to be a big problem for the market. A lot of frustration can come, and over a period of time what happens, VIX will come down, and even the premiums are going to come down, and it's going to be a very interesting market in the coming days. Let's see what's going to happen. And in the cash market, if you see here, okay, now some more buying is happening here. Now you can see the cash market price are going actually. So here the moving average, we can see some prices coming here above this. So if the price are going to fall below this, then only you have to be bothering about the cutting of your long position. Till the time, you can enjoy the ride. Whatever the market is, keep on giving the price on the upside. Keep on booking some profit, shift to your position and make some profit, book some profit, keep on booking some profits, either in mutual fund or the stocks, whatever. And some booking profits is going to give you some moral support in case of market suddenly crashing. So that time you'll have enough money to deploy more amount for buying stocks. So next week expiry, let us see the all these stock this position together. If you see for Nifty, you can see this in the buying mode, 15,000 this level, you can see very good resistance. So for tomorrow, 177 is a simple moving average. So anything like 15,000 call above 177, then you should be getting to long position. Till the time, if it coming to 175 levels, 150, 170 levels, it is going to be sell and rise only. If it is crossing 175, then only you have to be alert on the buy side. Otherwise, you can sell the call option 15,000. This is the moving average. And in case of 15,000 put option, or you can sell for this 15,000 put option, you can sell here at 150. 150 is the range here. So 170 for the 170, 175 for the call option, this is the resistance. And the support here, you get 150. If it's trying to go below, currently 176 is closed actually. And if it is going below 150, then just comfortably you can short the put option, also 15,000 put option. So overall, you're going to collect some almost like a 250, 60 points like that in premium in the first, this short strategy. And coming to the Bank Nifty, if you see here, 34,000 here, 34,000 call option, 424 is the moving average. And then in the case, the price is coming all the way to 257. 257 is going to 300, 350 is a very good price to short the position, 34,000 call options. And if it is crossing above 450, 425, this range, 400 and above, 425 that range, then you should not touch for shorting the call options. And in case of a put option, 33,000 put option, 400 is the stop loss. Currently closer to, sorry, 33,000 here. 33,000 is closer to 319. So once session is below 333, this is the range. So 300 below, it is a good price to short a 33,000 put option actually. So this is the range, just remember these levels, and then at least 100 points you should gain here. If the market is continuously going upside and then are remaining flat, then the 33,000 put option also gives some good money actually for shorting. And you can short 33,000 put option and buy some 31,000 put option or 31,500 put option, you can buy 600 rupees. And you can similarly, you can buy some 34,000 call, short 34,000 call option and buy some 35,500 call option or 35,000 call option. So together you're going to give around 100 rupees premium for buying options. And by shorting this, you're going to make almost like 500 rupees of a premium, the short strangle. So this kind of strategy is going to help at least make some 1500 points in Bank Nifty. At least if you're able to make this kind of a profits in Bank Nifty, to start with is a good trades. And in case of next thing we want to see is 33,500 short straddle. I want to just check what is the position. You see both are in sell mode. Now put is in the buy mode actually. So as I mentioned, 33,500, 495 is the level. So now once it goes below 500, then it's going to be a sell, put option, sell option opportunity. And here we may not get the buy opportunity 33,500 here. So this way I can select for any strike price and see whether what is selling mode or buying mode actually. And option chain two, okay, this is everything is sell mode and nothing more for this report actually. And coming to the Bitcoin, if you see here, Bitcoin is giving you another game. So if you see here, after touching 30,000 levels, again it just went to the 40,000 it recorded in just in no time. So yesterday at 6:30, today at like 9, that means almost 24 hours it recorded $13,000, now started coming down also. And our market also, like if you see SGX Nifty is almost seeing 100 points above. Our market Nifty futures closer 14,933. Now we are seeing SGX Nifty 100 points above actually. So this is another game is happening here, SGX Nifty. If you are seeing like if you have both calls and put options, then you can make money either way. What are the gap up or gap down? If you're having only one side, either you're shorting the put option or shorting the call option, then you have to be bothered about market tomorrow has to happen in the one side only. Then you have to pray to God for giving the move on the side what you wanted. Otherwise, one should not bother that the market is going to gap up or gap down. So try to take positions in both sides so that you make money on either side. Whether gap up or gap down, you'll make money. And if you see for the current today also what happened here, we got below the short breakout around 230 actually. Last 1 hour only the big game actually happened. Around 33,500 gave big move actually in case of Bank Nifty. 33,500 put option. Let us see 33,500 put option. The last 1 hour was a big mover actually. If you see here, we are almost like 2 o'clock trading on 30 rupees. 30 rupees went all the way to 233. Last 1 hour, just it is a gamble trade. That's it. If you just buy some put option and hold, whether it's just going to become hero or zero option, buy for 30 rupees like this and last 1 hour. But the problem is keeping that thing position till the expiry is going to be a problem. This is for many of them. I never tried like these options. Normally I go for shorting the call option, more calls and then more put options, less put options. The market is trending. But today also, like last week also same thing happened for the put option. What I put stop loss order, it got cancelled. Suddenly it's got cancelled and I have to manually, I have to square the positions. This is the thing, what is the big problem happening with the market participants. They don't allow the retailers to protect themselves using stop loss orders. There's a big cheating happening by the brokers or the exchange. We don't know what is happening actually, but definitely it is a traders are being cheated or looted by all these malpractices by the exchanges or brokers. So this nobody is there to ask, nobody can ask these things with the market. So we have to survey with whatever this thing happening in the market, no other option. So try to trade in the range bound market. There is no way that the market is trending, either is going to go on the upside or downside. There is no trending move we can see. And as I mentioned, that remember the 16th February high, which as of now is not planning to be broken. 16th February high, still we could not break actually. If you see here, it break 16th February high. And similarly for Bank Nifty also, we are not inside some range actually. If you see tomorrow being a weekly close also, we are just 4 weeks continuously we are inside a range, small range actually, which is 33,400 and 32,300. So roughly 2,000 points range we are inside and we are not going anywhere actually. This mother candle, whatever we found here, almost we have corrected actually. This is whatever candle we saw in February, this almost got corrected. Again, we are trying to make move. Just trying to go every high is being sold. And in case of Nifty, if you see, Nifty is also very tight range in last 4 months, so 4 weeks. If you see here, it is in tight range 14,955 and here 14,500. 4,500 points more range only. So every tip selling the put option, every raise selling the call option. This is what's happening. As of now, no great movement is happening in the market. So try to trade some intraday trades. That's the only way you can get to the market. Stay cautious. As of now, there is no worry about market getting into the bearish mode, big bearish mode. Just moving time, doing time pass. We will see some trending move. It's going to come. When it's going to come, can handle. Till the time, enjoy some rides on the upside and downside both. Thank you so much. Hope you like the video. If you like the video, subscribe and like the channel. Thank you.